your vectors? That was the first thing we did. Was in this. Yeah. Unfortunately, that's not on the test. It's a movie. It's a funny movie, but vectors. Remember it?
Yes.
Okay. So there's three problems on the test. Vectors. First one.
Three
vector problems.
Wow.
Nice try. Nice try.
I would not.
I would risk it all.
And there's only three questions?
I kind of like to live life on the edge.
Yeah.
If we had,
you would enjoy
a test every other day with one question on the test, I would
stay like for you.
I want to sit here and
okay. Vector, doesn't this mean vector u?
Yep.
Is 18. The direction angle is 72 degrees. Find the x and the y component, and that's what the test says. All right, draw the vector. All right? 72 degrees, like that. This is 18, this is 72 degrees. Do you see a triangle? By extending this straight down? A right triangle? Isn't this x? And this y.
Yep.
How would I find x?
We're using like the law of sine and the law of cosine.
No, just sine and cosine or tangent. X. Would that use sine or cosine?
Cosine.
So the cosine of 72 is equal to x over 18? Do you agree with that? What's x?
18 times the cosine of 72.
Very good. Round to the nearest tenth.
Yes, 5.6.
X is 5.6. How would I find y?
Use the diagram here, right?
Or sine of 72. Is y over 18? You can do it either way, Sammy. What is y?
17.1.
Is that what you all got? That was not difficult, was it? That's what's on the test mark.
That's it.
Whoa.
Hey. Can we do another one of those?
Can we wait till the end to make sure we have time? Now, what if I give you two vectors? Vector u and vector v. Let's say u is 21, v is 26, and the angle between them is 80 degrees. Doesn't that mean this is 26? Because V is always on the horizon. This is 21, and this is 80 degrees. Do you remember this?
Yeah.
What I wanted to find was this value right there. So I moved this vector over here.
Right. Oh, I do remember this.
What is my angle in my triangle? 100 degrees. So this is Z. How do I find Z? Because these two are supplementary. Cosines. So Z squared equals 26 squared plus 21 squared minus 2 times 26 times 21 cosine of 100. Do you remember this? What is Z?
36.1.
I want to find one more thing. I want to find this little angle right here we will call theta. What? Using the law of sines. So the sine of theta over 21 equals the sine of 100 over 36.1.
I did.
Fix your song to yourself.
Oh, okay.
Is that what you got? Theta is 35 degrees. Right? Good. One more vector problem. An airplane has an airspeed of 450 miles an hour. Heading of 70 degrees. Don't we always start from the north? So this is 70 and this is 450. The wind is blowing from the north, 36 miles an hour. Is it blowing it down or up?
Yeah.
Good. So this is 36, correct? I want to find this value right here. Don't I?
Yeah.
Isn't this angle 70? So Z squared equals 450 squared plus 36 squared, right? Minus 2 times 450. Times 36 cosine of 70. what's 439 watt? Okay, so the plane is going 439 miles per hour. How do I find the direction? Can I find this little angle right here? Yes? So the sine of theta over 36 equals the sine of 70 over 439. You're correct, because I asked for the little angle. This is 4.4 degrees. So what is my angle that the plane is going? 74.4 degrees. Right? Okay, you've got done three problems with the test. Have you made an A?
Yes.
Lily didn't like the first one.
I didn't like any of those.
Excuse me, I'm just concerned about how we get to what we've been doing.
I know, yeah.
Yeah. See, what I'm scared about is that...
Remember X is X. How did you get them wrong?
That's the thing that confuses me. Just like I'm doing them right, and I get the right answers, and I don't have to cheat them. I did really bad.
Don't
poke there. Find the midpoint. You remember midpoint?
Oh, shoot. I do not. Maybe the formula.
I just find the average of the x's, the average of the y's, right? Isn't this the x 3/2?
Yes.
And the y is 3? Is that right?
-3?
No. Oh, it is. Yes.
I was going to say this was easy, and then I was like, wait.
Okay. How do I find the distance between the two points? Remember this? Subtract the x's squared plus subtract the y's squared.
Oh, I thought it was x two.
It doesn't matter.
No.
As long as you do it the same for both of them,
it doesn't matter which one's first. So this is 81 plus 100. Is radical 181? Does that simplify? Always check it, right? Okay, this is midpoint. That's two formulas you have to know, right? All right. Now, if I give you this equation, can you find the x-intercepts? X-intercepts. What do I let equal zero?
Y.
Y. don't?
No.
So if y is 0, what is x?
This is an easy one. It's 6.
X equals 6.
So it is?
6 comma 0.
6, 0. Now let's go the other way. Let's find the y-intercept. What happens now?
X equals 0.
I picked a bad problem is what happened. Y squared equals negative 3. Can y squared equal negative 3?
No.
So there's no y-intercept.
Wait. How can we get negative 3?
I divided by negative 2.
Oh, I definitely,
So, you wanted a hard one, Sammy?
Sure.
Okay, this one. What's my x-intercept?
8.
So it is 8, 0. Finding the x-intercept.
2.
For the y-intercept.
It's I get
2 y squared equals 8. Y squared is 4. So is it 0, 2 and 0, negative 2?
I thought it couldn't be negative, though, since it's squared.
But it's plus or minus.
When I square root, this can't be negative.
Yeah, I see that.
Because that should be fairly simple. Is it? Okay.
This vector should be the entire test.
Well, it's not. That makes it harder.
Is this the circle formula?
This is circle. The directions say find the center and the radius of the circle. What is the center?
-3, -5.
What's the radius?
Square root of 60.
That should be easy.
I like that.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
Still on circles. Write the equation of the circle and graph it. Can you?
I don't think so. I'm not gonna lie.
Put the x's together. X squared plus 6x, right? Plus y squared minus 2y equals negative 6. Remember that? Then, for this piece, I took half of 6 and squared it, right? Which is what? So I have x squared plus 6x plus 9, and over here I add 9 because I have to add it to both sides. What about the y's?
1.
Plus y squared minus 2y plus 1 plus 1, right? Now, does this factor? What? X plus 3 squared plus equals 4. What's my center?
3.
1.
Yeah.
And my radius?
2.
So my circle?
Oh, we have a graph?
Sorry. Looks like that. Liz, did that make sense to you?
Yeah, I remember it.
You probably weren't here then, were you?
Well,
yeah. Not near as much fun. I like circles. And circles are going to be on the ACT, so you better know them.
I just think it's too, I'd rather not be reminded of.
When are you taking it?
I'm kind of excited.
February 6th.
It's crazy to see how much I've improved since it's crazy. I mean, I feel like I'm a little smarter.
I scored drop from the pre-ACT.
So dang.
What is
open for double digits?
F of 2. It's all relative, isn't it? What's F of 2? Negative 2?
I agree.
All I did was put 2 in everywhere there was an X, right?
Yeah, I just had to work it out. People were a little fast.
What is F of X plus H? Doesn't that mean I have X plus H squared minus 3?
X squared
times
plus
x plus h?
H plus h squared.
Okay, so wait, say it again. X squared plus what?
2xh plus h squared minus 3x minus 3h.
Well, then you want to keep going, Cass.
I'm checking.
Please hope there's
not. No.
Okay.
That's all good then?
Yeah.
All right. If I tell you this is your favorite kind of problem, what's the domain? To what?
A 1. And 1 to infinity. See, those parts are easy. It's whenever we start getting radicals and the denominators, and that is not
good. Yeah.
How do I do the domain?
Oh, the radical cannot equal, has to be greater than or equal to 0.
Do you agree? So what is x?
It's negative, I mean positive.
Greater than or equal to 3?
Yeah.
How do I write that?
So.
I thought you all told me domain was hard.
Whoever gets
well, these are the easy problems, though, that's the thing. So.
Well, that's all that's on the test.
Oh, okay.
Problems like this.
Wait, so there's really? None in the denominator?
Well, that was a denominator.
Yeah, but
that's
like,
different.
No.
That's an even denominator. Not one with an absolute value or an x squared plus 6x.
Okay. The last thing on the test is a graph with questions like yesterday. Do you want to do one of those?
Yes.
Yeah.
What is f of negative 2?
F 3.
What the y is. X is 1.
Yeah. 3? Okay. Find all x when f of x equals 1. Okay, so I'm going to, in squigglies, I'm going to say this is about 8 3/4, negative, right?
Negative half.
Negative a half.
Positive half.
Positive half.
And then in the squiggly lines, and then you have...
Five.
Five infinity.
And in a bracket.
Yeah.
We agree?
No.
What's wrong?
I'm lost.
Okay, I want to know when y is 1.
Yes.
It happened here.
Oh, yeah.
It happened here. Here. That was all these.
Okay.
And then this picked up here.
Okay, I got it now.
Okay. The next question, what is the x-intercept?
Oh, it's...
There's only one.
Zero, zero.
Yeah.
Zero, zero?
Yep.
What's the y-intercept?
Zero, zero.
Zero, zero.
Wait, is there only one in everything? Or...
No, there could be more than one, but this one is an open circle, so
oh,
it's not an intercept.
Yeah.
What's the domain?
Of x? My domain is all of x.
It's negative.
In parentheses?
Yeah, parentheses.
To what?
To three.
Three with a?
Parentheses.
And then bracket five.
Radical. Or not radical. I mean, 12.
Does that make sense?